हेलो स्टूडेंट, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर नरेंद्र सिंह, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन फिजिक्स, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बेसिक साइंसेस, ओरिएंटल कॉलेज ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, भोपाल। टुडे वी विल स्टडी हियर द इलेक्ट्रिक डिस्प्लेसमेंट एंड द डाइलेक्ट्रिक्स। सो हियर इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव द सर्टेन टॉपिक्स विच वी आर जस्ट गोइंग टू कवर। दीज टॉपिक्स आर इलेक्ट्रिक डिस्प्लेसमेंट, dielectrics and the types of the electrics and effect of electric field on the dielectrics. So the first of all we will study here, that is the electric displacement. So we know that the electric field strength E not only depends upon the magnitude of the magnitude and position of the charge Q, but also depends upon the dielectric constant of the medium in which the electric field is to be measured. Therefore, it is desirable to associate with the charge Q with another quantity which is depends upon the medium involved. This quantity is known as your electric flux, or it is known as your electric displacement, and it having the same character that of your the charge. So we can write it as psi is equal to Q. Here this psi is nothing, that is your electric flux or the electric displacement, and it having the same character, same nature that of the charge. So the electric displacement per unit area is also known as, that is known as your electric flux density. We know that the at any point on a spherical surface of radius r centered at the isolated charge Q will be that we can write it as D is equal to psi upon 4 pi r square, and it will be equal to Q upon 4 pi r square coulomb per meter square. Here this Q is equal to, Q is nothing, that is the charge which is just kept at a particular point and it is isolated, and it will be equal to the psi, that is nothing, psi is nothing, that is your electric displacement. The displacement per unit area at a given point depends upon the direction of the area, and therefore the displacement density D is a vector quantity. The direction of the D is taken as the direction of the normal to the surface element, which makes the displacement maximum through the elemental area. That means the direction of this displacement flux density is nothing, but it is perpendicular that particular area which we have taken, and at that particular area the electric displacement is your maximum. That is nothing, but that is the direction of this electric flux density. So equation 1 we can write it as D is equal to psi upon 4 pi r square, and that will be equal to Q upon 4 pi r square into ar. Here we have taken that Q is equal to psi, and ar nothing, that is the unit vector which is normal to the area at which this flux density is your maximum. So equation 1 we can write it as D is equal to Q upon 4 pi r square. Here we have multiplied numerator and denominator by psi, and that will be equal to psi Q upon 4 pi epsilon r square. This Q upon 4 pi epsilon r square is nothing, but that is the electric field. So we can write it as that will be equal to psi into E, or we can write it as D is equal to epsilon E. Here D is nothing, that is your electric displacement density. So this D and E fields will have exactly the same form. The difference only by the factor which is the dielectric constant of the medium in which we have just measuring the electric field. If this we have taken the air in which the this electric field is measured, then for air we can represent this epsilon, that is equal to epsilon naught. Now here we have the dielectrics. So dielectrics are the material in which the positive and the negative charges are so tightly bonded they are inseparable, and hence it has the conductivity zero. So such type of materials are known as your, these are known as your dielectrics. And in dielectrics, the relation between the electric flux density and the electric field is nothing but that is equal to D is equal to epsilon into E, where this epsilon is nothing, that is known as your the permittivity of the medium. And in free space, this D is equal to epsilon naught E, here epsilon naught is the permittivity in air. There are two types of your dielectrics. One is known as your polar dielectrics and other one is your non-polar dielectrics. Here we will study one by one the polar dielectrics as well as your the non-polar dielectrics. So the first one is your polar dielectrics. So the polar dielectrics are nothing but these are the molecules in which the center of the positive charge does not coincide with the center of the negative charges. Such a molecules are known as your polar molecules. For example, we have the HCl, we have the water, we have the ammonia, etc. We can see in this particular figure of your water. So both the positive charges as well as your negative charges does not coincide the to each other. In the diagram as given below, then we did not apply this electric field, that is your E is equal to zero. At that particular case, the permanent dipoles of the molecules orient in the random directions, and hence the net dipole moment is zero. But it means in this case, these dipoles are moving in the random directions. They are not aligned in the in a particular direction. So therefore, what should be the value of your this dipole moment? P is equal to 0 phi, P is equal to Q into 2L. So we cannot measure this 2L properly. So therefore, this dipole moment is 0 for your this polar molecules. However, then we applied this electric field, then what will happen? These dipoles start to move in the direction of your applied field. So what will happen? We will get some value of your this dipole moment, so as shown in the figure. So simply, in your polar molecules, when the electric field is not applied, then the dipole moment is zero. When the electric field is applied, then the dipole moment having some value. The next one is your non-polar molecules. The non-polar molecules are nothing but these are the molecules in which the center of positive charges coincide with the center of the negative charge. So what will happen? Such type of molecules are known as your non-polar molecules. For example, N2CH4O2C6H6 etc. We can also see here in case of your non-polar molecules, then in the absence of your electric field, these positive charge as well as your negative charge does not just separate to each other. So and hence here the dipole moment having the value zero. However, when we applied some electric field to the non-polar molecules, then what will happen? So there is some separation between the positive charge as well as your the negative charge after the application of electric field, and hence we will get some value of your dipole moment. So so that's all from these polar as well as your the non-polar molecules. Thank you very much.